Churchill and Roosevelt, and what did they do with his power? As a gift, illustrated in his great work, Greatest Story Never Told. Yes, if you want to see the dangers that are facing the world today, just watch this film. Once you see the actual facts, indisputable facts of what really happened at that time.
The story began here in the Austrian town of Braunau, with a child born in this house, Adolf Hitler. At his peak, the most popular ruler in Europe. The child born here in Braunau belonged to that handful of human beings who have clearly and decisively changed the history of the 20th century. Linz, Austria, the site of the only memorial to the Hitler family, the grave of Hitler's parents. Nothing about his parents or Adolf's early life gave any hint of the extraordinary career that was to come. His father, Alois, was a stern, short-tempered customs official who beat his son. His mother, Clara, tried to protect him. When she died, young Adolf was broken by grief. He kept her portrait with him for the rest of his life. The infant Adolf was baptized and brought up as a Catholic. At the age of 6, he entered the monastery school at Lambach. Soon, he was top of his class. Hitler was a chorister at the great Abbey Church of Lambach. "I used," he said, "to intoxicate myself with the solemn splendor of the services." Every day when he sang in the choir, he saw the memorial to an earlier abbot. Above it was an emblem which a quarter of a century later, Hitler was to adopt for the Nazi party, the swastika. In his teens, Hitler became a moody adolescent. At secondary school in Linz, he lost interest in most of his work. His ambition was to go to Vienna and become an artist or architect. Once there, he produced architectural drawings and watercolors like these. Competent, but not good enough to win the place he longed for at the Viennese Academy of Fine Arts. After the shock of being turned down twice by the Academy of Fine Arts, he became a drifter. Hitler later called his period in Vienna the most miserable time of my life. 3 of those miserable years were spent here in a Viennese backstreet at this hostel for homeless men. In this depressing hostel, the future Führer passed much of the day sitting with other inmates, churning out drawings and watercolors which earned him a modest income. When he drifted from Vienna to Germany in 1913, he was still dreaming of becoming a great artist or famous architect. Munich, the 1st of August, 1914. A cheering crowd welcomes the outbreak of the First World War. On the right is a photographer, and among the crowd he's photographing is the 25-year-old Adolf Hitler.